guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Lauren back with a new grocery haul video for you. Today, I'm heading over to Aldi to do a nice big weekly grocery haul stock up. It's been a while since I headed to Aldi for our weekly haul. I've done Costco and Walmart. A couple weeks ago, I went to Trader Joe's, so time to mix it up. Aldi is always one of my staple stores to go to when I'm looking to restock my pantry with tons of good, healthy, and affordable food for my family. So I thought I would sit and share my meal plan for the week with you guys real quick before I head into the store and show you the haul, mostly because Lila fell asleep on our way here and I want to give her a little car nap. I thought I would just take a minute and talk through my weekly meal plan that I made and my grocery list before we head in and I share the whole haul with you guys. So typically when I meal plan, I'll just come up with like a few ideas for breakfast and lunch options, and then I'll actually plan out my dinners for the week. When I plan dinner, I like to plan 3 or 4 meals I'm gonna cook, and then I always reserve 2 nights as like leftovers or quick from the freezer kind of nights, and then usually 1 night I'll save on reserve for figure it out that day or a takeaway night. So on the menu this week, I have a pork fried rice because we have some leftover shredded pork I need to get used up. So I'm gonna DIY our own Chinese takeaway with pork fried rice 1 night. We're also gonna be making the TikTok feta pasta. If you guys have been following me for a while, you guys know my family absolutely loves feta pasta, and my husband requested it this week for our pasta dish. So I usually will only make pasta like once a week, and then sometimes we'll have the leftovers for a second night, but I usually plan one pasta dish a week because I know my whole family, pasta queen over there, will eat it. So we're gonna do the TikTok feta pasta. I'm also gonna do a little twist on grilled cheese sandwiches 1 night and do a caprese grilled cheese, so more like a panini, I guess. But we have tons of basil I want to get used up and some mozzarella left at home, so I just need some good fresh tomatoes and good bread, and we'll make those for dinner 1 night. And then actually starting tonight, we're swinging into Costco as well, which I literally need like 2 things at Costco, so I probably won't include that in the haul, but I'm gonna pick up a rotisserie chicken while I'm there because I always do every time I'm at Costco, and that's what we'll have tonight along with a salad, and then I'll use the leftover rotisserie chicken and some other ingredients and make up my white chicken enchiladas. They're one of our absolute favorites and we haven't had them in a few weeks. I will link the video above with the white chicken enchilada recipe. It's truly one of my staple meals. We make it every month, sometimes multiple times a month. When I first started on my health journey on WW, we made the white chicken enchiladas once a week. They were a staple in getting us started on our weight loss journey. They're so delicious, great flavor, and they're really low in point for a dinner. So anyway, that's what's on the plan for this week. I am gonna give Little Miss another couple minutes to rest. She's so sweet. And then we're gonna head into Aldi and I will check in when I get home with you guys and share our whole haul, including everything we need for our meals, breakfast, lunches, and snacks. Hey guys, okay, I am finally home. Oh, okay, so we ran into Aldi to go grocery shopping, and then for some reason, I really feel like Aldi was out of a lot of our staples that we normally pick up there, or things just like didn't look that good, which is not usually the case for me in Aldi. I love Aldi. I have a warm spot in my heart for Aldi. I think it was just because I went on a Sunday early evening, so they were just out of things. So the best time to shop at Aldi is always midweek. You avoid crowds. They're always restocked better. Anyway. Moving on. So I went there and got what I could, and then I did have to pop into Costco anyway for those couple things. And I mean, I wasn't going to show the Costco haul because I needed like 2 items. Has anyone ever walked out of Costco with only 2 items? I never walk out of there without spending at least $100. So there you go. I got a little Costco haul for you too. If you guys are new to my channel, I am on a health and wellness journey. One of my goals is to lose 150 pounds. So far, I'm just over 72 pounds down. I follow the WW Green Plan right now. I followed the WW Blue Plan for almost 2 years. I just switched it up to the Green Plan this month, and I'm going to see how mixing it up helps reboot my journey and get my weight loss rolling after being on a plateau. Anyway, let's jump into the hauls. Like always, down here in the bottom bar, you will find WW points for all plans, as well as calories and prices for all items, because we are trying to stay healthy and affordable this week. So first up, starting with the Costco haul, they had some really great deals going on at Costco. So make sure you check out your local Costco and their flyers. They have a lot of specials on snacks and things like that for back to school. Chobani was one of those great deals I found. This huge 20 pack of the Chobani non-fat Greek yogurts with fruit on the bottom was only like, wanna say $9.99. Check the bottom bar for the exact price, but that's a great deal. These do, the fruit on the bottom ones do run a little bit higher in points than the Light and Fit Greek yogurts that I normally get. Hopefully they're good. They're mostly for my husband. He likes to have something to grab and go for work, so we have yogurts. I also picked up a 24 pack of eggs to use for breakfast. I think I'm gonna use these and do a little breakfast meal prep as well this week. Of course, this is honestly one of the two things I went for because my family can't be without these in the house. These are complete dupes for Chick-fil-A nuggets. We put them in our air fryer. They have air fryer instructions right on the back here for you to follow. So simple, such a great, easy dinner or lunch to have on hand. We make these into buffalo wraps. We put some Frank's hot sauce on them, or we'll put them in salads. We'll do other kinds of like ranch wraps, or my kiddo just eats them plain as is with some fruit for lunch. So we love having these on hand. I ended up picking up this massive package of the Babybel cheeses. These come in at 3 points on the WW plans, and these are so tasty. I love having one of these and like some turkey. You'll see I, at Aldi, that's all to be unpacked yet. I picked up some turkey, like pepperoni and turkey snack sticks. And sometimes I like just to make a little adult charcuterie snack plate for lunch. That's one of my faves. So I grabbed some of those. I got a double pack of fresh mozzarella. My basil plant is doing super well. So we're gonna do some caprese salads for lunches. And then I also told you guys about that dinner. We're doing like the caprese paninis. That'll be yummy. This is the Sara Lee artisano bread. I love at Costco, they come in a two pack. My family flies through bread. I don't know about you guys, but I always grab the two packs so I can put one in the freezer, have one out. My daughter and husband love to eat this for toast or sandwiches. I'll use a single piece of it because I think it runs about 3 points on the WW plans. I'll use one piece and make avocado toast for myself in the morning. This is our dinner for tonight, because yikes, it's already almost 6 o'clock. I gotta get rolling. This is a rotisserie chicken. I always pick one up at Costco. They're such a good deal. Fun fact, they put these at the back of the store. They lose money on these. That's how little they cost compared to other stores and the cost of the product. They lose money to only sell them at that price, but they put them at the back of the store, so you have to walk all the way back to get them and you buy a million other things on your way. Fun fact. All right, so we're having that. I'm just gonna shred it up. As long as you do the rotisserie chicken and remove all of the skin and fat and stuff, on the blue plan, rotisserie chicken breast counted for 0 points. On the green plan, now that I've switched, I believe it counts as 1 point for the chicken breast with the skin removed. I also picked up one of their Mediterranean crunch chopped salads. I absolutely adore this salad. It's so good and it's such a nice mix up. It's a huge bag of salad. So I will mix up this kit and I will keep the dressing on the side. What I really love about it is it comes with the dressing is separated into two packets. So I will just go ahead and divide this salad in half. We'll do half for tonight with the chicken. The other half I'll keep to the side for some lunch prep and the dressing on the side in its packet, and we'll just make it up as we go for the week. Grab some oven roasted turkey breast. This was ringing in at 0 points on the WW green plan. So I'm still kind of figuring out from blue to green what now has points that didn't on blue. This definitely was 0 points on the blue plan. It's ringing in for zero on the green. I'm gonna double check that before I eat it, but yeah, we're just gonna have this for wraps and sandwiches and things. This is mainly what I cook with. It's avocado oil spray. I pick it up in the two pack at Costco. It lasts me for forever, but I like to use that in my pans or like to spray on things I'm putting in the air fryer. Usually I don't even use enough of it that it's more than 0 points. So it just counts as 0 points when I'm cooking. And then I had not seen the large container of the ranch seasoning before at Costco, at mine anyway. So I picked this up. I love to make my own ranch dressing, and I use non-fat plain Greek yogurt and the dry ranch mix. And then you can always add a little bit of milk or water to make it your consistency for drizzling or whatever. That's delicious. I also picked up this Faye non-fat Greek yogurt with the ranch dressing in mind, but also to use in a billion other things. I use it in cooking and baking and everything. And then of course, It's been a while since we've picked up our salsa. I love the Farm Stand mild salsa. I like to use salsa with my eggs a lot in the morning for breakfast. So there you go. Costco got me $125 for this haul.
I am so sorry. It just occurred to me, I was probably talking really fast. That's one thing I try and work on is slowing down, especially when I'm doing a haul on like a day where I've just gotten home from the grocery store. I gotta get dinner on the table. It's like that mom thing. You know what I mean? I'm so sorry. Let's take a look at the Aldi haul. I will try and slow down and breathe.
Because we didn't get enough yogurt at Costco, Lila saw these and they were on sale for $1.99 at Aldi today. So I picked her up some of the Danimal smoothies. She loves sipping these out of a straw for like lunches or breakfasts. Cheese, I picked up a 1 pound bag of mild cheddar. They also had the reduced fat sharp cheddar at Aldi today. I have such a hard time finding reduced fat cheese in my area, so I went ahead and picked up a bag. I do love my full fat cheese. If you guys have followed me for a long time, you know I normally just prefer to use it, but I figured since I actually found it this week and I'm in the middle of getting back on track with my WW, counting all my points, going on to green for the first time, I figured let's get the reduced fat cheese and see how I can work that into my points. And if I still feel like I have enough points left in the day, I'll switch back to full fat cheese. But anyway, I picked those up. And then I picked up some 2% milk, mostly for Lila, and Josh drinks it too. I have almond milk still in the fridge from last week. I picked up some hash browns. I think I'm gonna use these in a meal prep this week. I'm thinking of doing some like breakfast egg cups. I've done those before on the channel and they're really good, really easy, and you can pop them right in the microwave. So stay tuned. I think I'm gonna film a meal prep for this week as well, since I'm getting back on track and I need everything to go smoothly this week. I did pick up some Stoke cold brew. I have not bought cold brew in the longest time. I do have a cold brew pitcher, which is always linked in my description if you're interested in taking a peek at it. It does save me a lot of money in the long run, but I just was feeling some Stoke this week. They had this on special at the front of Aldi, and ooh, that's one thing I forgot to share from Costco. It's out in the garage. I got a case of Premier Protein. If you love Profi coffee and doing protein and espresso mixed together as coffee in the morning, run to Costco the next couple weeks. They have their big 30 pack cases on sale for $7 off their normal price. So go get your Premier Proteins if that's something you like, but my thought is I'm just gonna mix that with this or with espresso shots from my Nespresso maker. That's my coffee for the week. And then I have a couple bags of frozen broccoli. I did pick up some orange Sunday shop bars. These are just like creamsicles. We've had them once before. I believe they come in at 4 points on the WW plans, and they are so, so yummy. They're a great little treat. That's one of my favorite things to do when I'm trying to get back on track with healthy eating or switching my WW plan. All of that considered, I like to have a couple treats in the house that I know the points of, that I know I can work into my weekly points allotment or calorie allotment. And that way I can still have a sweet treat at the end of the night if I'm feeling something and I don't have to fight that craving of wanting to run out for ice cream or something like that. And then just some sweet potato fries. We'll pop these in the air fryer with either the chicken nuggets from Costco for quick meals or, you know, dinners and stuff like that, easy. And then I also grabbed I guess this is a 2-pack, but it's weird. They're like butterflied. I don't know. This is probably 4 portions of pork chops, in my opinion. It looks like they just split them and they're still connected. So I will probably split those apart and it'll be 4 servings. And I think I'm gonna make my bacon wrap pork chops. That's another great recipe. I've shared it more recently on the channel. I will link that video in the iCard above. So yum. All right, this is my cold stuff. I'm gonna real quick put this away. And then I'll get to my other 2 bags. Hang with me, we're almost there. Let's get through the rest of the haul. And here's the rest of my Aldi haul. If you guys are interested in more information on these bags, I get questions every time I do an Aldi haul on them. They're the Lotus trolley bags, and I have them linked in the description below. My absolute favorite reusable bags. They come in a set of 4. There's 3 different sizes of bags that have like a mesh bottom on them. And then this one really big insulated bag, which is great. When you have to run to multiple stores to be able to put your frozen and cold items in there, they truly stayed cold the whole time. I ran into Costco after Aldi and got home. Everything was still nice and cold and then got put away. So highly recommend. They're in the description though if you want more information. So for produce this week, I picked up some Pink Lady apples, a fresh pineapple, 2 pounds of strawberries. So I have some raspberries as well this week, a English cucumber for a little lunch prep recipe. Here are those big tomatoes on the vine. I'll use these in that caprese panini. I have a couple mangoes. These are not ripe yet, so I will let probably one sit on the counter and put one away in the fridge so they ripen over the course of the week. And I'll have, usually I eat half at a time with like breakfast. I really like mangoes. And then I have some cherub little grape tomatoes. This is for our feta pasta recipe. You put this in with a block of feta. You roast it off in the oven until the tomatoes start to burst open, and then you add in pasta and it makes its own sauce. It's the simplest, easy, most delicious thing ever. I needed some paper goods while I was at Aldi, and they always have such a great price on paper goods. I grabbed a 2-pack of paper towels, but these are like the jumbo paper towels. I'll just go through these. It'll take me at least a week to go through 2 of these. I don't use paper towels a lot. I try my best to use reusable microfiber cloths, but I like to have these on hand for big messes with the toddler and the dog and stuff. So anyway, got those. I grabbed some more gallon freezer bags. Usually I use these for meal preps that I'm doing in the freezer, things like that. Some more kitchen trash bags. I did pick up a couple of these flavored waters. I've never tried them before. I know they contain aspartame. Don't come for me. Granted, I also drink the occasional diet soda, so it is what it is. But then I had to kind of restock some of my like pantry staples. I got some banana pepper rings. We love adding these to like our turkey wraps, or I'll even skip the wrap part and do them in like lettuce cups. But adding the pepper rings, ooh, that's so good. They're like tangy and a little bit spicy to that turkey wrap. So good. This hot sauce, it's just like Frank's Red Hot Sauce, but they didn't carry that brand at Aldi. So I grabbed this. We'll do this on top of those chicken nuggets after we air fry them. We'll toss them in a little bit of this and have some like buffalo style nuggets that we'll either put into wraps or on salads. Super good. A couple cans of black beans. My daughter loves black beans. She actually got mad at my husband last week because he came home from the grocery store. We just needed like odds and ends to get us through the week after we got home from a trip last week, and she got mad at him, actually mad at him, because he forgot to bring black beans from the store. 3-year-old life. Anyway, we also got some diced tomatoes. I always just like having these on hand, and I noticed I was out of them in my pantry. And also the diced tomatoes with green chilies. This is going to be for that enchilada recipe. I couldn't find regular green chilies in the can at Aldi. They didn't have just plain green chilies, like mild green chilies diced. So I got a can of this. It's basically the same as Rotel. That'll work in the recipe too. I didn't want to get them at Costco and end up with like 16 of them. So we're making it work. And I didn't want to stop at a third grocery store. So that's what it is. And then one more canned item. I was trying to show Lila some different things at the store. I need to start figuring out some more things that she will eat for lunches that I can send with to preschool. She starts preschool for the first time. She's 3 years old in just a couple weeks, and I'm like dying to figure out some more items that aren't like warm food that I can send with her in a lunchbox. So I was thinking maybe she could try some mandarin oranges. Oh, I just realized this one says in light syrup. That wasn't my intention. I typically have grabbed in the past the ones in water. I just grabbed this off the shelf. Oh well. Anyway, I'll have her try these and see if she even likes the texture of them. She's struggled with mandarin oranges before. If you guys have toddlers, other mamas out there, help me out. This is my first time having a kid going to school, going to preschool. She's kind of a picky eater. It's weird. She's picky about certain things. Lunch is particularly hard for us. Dinner time, I can usually tweak whatever we're eating and she'll go along with it. Lunchtime is so hard. Other than peanut butter and jelly and quesadillas, and like chicken nuggets, but that's warm, I really struggle. So if you guys can give me some ideas down below, I'm gonna do some research too, and maybe I can find a few things, and I'll share a whole video on some food prep for the family and doing like some lunch stuff for kids. But let me know if you guys have any suggestions or anything to look into, and I will. Josh and I love to snack on this kind of stuff. It's the turkey snack sticks. I've gotten the old Wisconsin ones before, but these are like the Aldi brand that they carry, so I'm excited to try those out. And then some turkey pepperoni. We love having these on hand for when we make our pizza bombs. That is such a great family-friendly recipe. We all love when we do pizza night. We do two-ingredient dough with Greek yogurt and self-rising flour, and then we just stuff it with some mozzarella cheese and some pepperoni. You dip it in zero-point marinara sauce. So yummy. I have shared that a couple times on my channel. For snacks, I let Lila pick some things out. She wanted some new pretzel twists. She likes these honey wheat ones, so that's something she'll eat. I grabbed some reduced-fat wheat thins to have for crackers and meat and cheese. So there you go. I like a good charcuterie plate. She also picked out some animal crackers. We really didn't have a ton of like kid snacks, so I told her she could pick two things. And we have a ton of fruit and stuff like that she snacks on as well, and dry cereal throughout the day. So, and obviously we also have the yogurt restocked in the fridge too. So she has plenty of snacky stuff. I grabbed a couple boxes of pasta just to kind of have on hand. I have one package of pasta that I'm going to use for the feta pasta, and I don't really have a plan for these, but I always like to have a couple boxes on hand just in case if it's a dinner I don't think Lila will eat, which is rare, but it happens. If it's truly something I think she'll struggle with, sometimes I'll just make up some plain pasta with steamed broccoli and a little mozzarella cheese, and that's like her favorite dinner ever. And then I actually grabbed this chunky blue cheese dressing for Josh because he wanted that with the buffalo sauced nuggets. Okay, I think I got it all. So I ended up spending $85 at Aldi and $125 at Costco, which I don't think is too bad. It was a pretty big stock up. It's the beginning of the month. I'm trying to keep our budget down this month, but that means I've only at this point spent just over $200 for the month, and this is gonna seriously last me through next week, and a lot of these items, especially the Costco stuff, will last the month. So we're doing pretty good. My goal from here, since this is my big stock for the month, will be to spend between $75 and $100 a week for the next couple weeks throughout the rest of the month. So anyway, that's where we're at. That's my Costco and Aldi haul. Thank you guys so much for joining me today, for checking out my grocery haul. I hope you enjoyed tracking along the WW points, calories, and prices. I love trying new products and grocery items, so leave me your recommendations down below. Hit the like button if you enjoyed seeing my healthy, affordable grocery haul. Hit the subscribe if you want to check out more of my videos and keep up to date with my weight loss updates. And until next time, bye! I always do. I never think, I always do.